direction, but worth the effort, don't you think?
Yes, perfect.
Really? Perfect? Then maybe one of you could explain to me why Rodomy, one destined to be my one and only, is neglecting me. He's been to see his father. He's been to see my father. He's practically chummed it up with other withered man in Egypt. And apparently, the fact of visiting a ripe young princess with fabulous hair keeps him cool.
Princess Imnaris, first in beauty, wisdom, and accessories. Captain Rodomy has not forgotten about you. He knows you'll be at the feast tonight, all your extravagant finery. But for now, he sends you this gift.
Another handmaiden? I don't need another handmaiden. Does this gift have a name?
Aida. Did you just say? My name is Aida, princess. And I think you might wish to know
how
that—
How dare you! You do not lower your eyes.
Do not tremble. Are you not afraid of me? Would it please you if I were?
Not so much.
Then I'm doing as you wish.
Very well. You were saying something about
Captain Rodney's.
What other captain?
Only that he's well. He suffered no injuries in battle, and I thought you might wish to know that.
I did. I've been so... You're very astute, aren't you, Aida?
Only on occasion. My true talent lies in the needle. If you allow me, princess, I'll make the world into shapes of your eyes. There's a diamond cross inside of it, handed down from the handmaids, the queen of